ultimate combo.
Welcome everyone to Twisted Gaming TV. Today we're going to do another video of WreckFest. I'm going to kind of do another review. This is kind of an ending review. Since I did the first review when I started the game, and then I've progressed a lot in the game, so I'm just kind of going to do a little review over what I think of the game as of now. So we're at the first one, the second, the third challengers, and fourth pro and internationals. Now we're at the world masters, and we're going to start off with Dirt Devil Stadium, aka the Bermuda Triangle track that I love. So let's check it out. Now this one's probably going to be a lot harder because, you know, we're the world champions now, so we'll see how tough this really gets. I'm sure there'll be more laps because in the past ones, you know, you could go up to 6 laps in a race, and I'm thinking in the end on this one it's probably gonna be 12 laps. So, you know, we'll see. You know, and the more laps you got, the harder it is, because, you know, your car is just, you know, not much of anything anymore. It's destroyed by then. So let's check it out and see what happens. Yeah, so this would be really tough if on a 12 lap of this. I mean, it's probably gonna be one of those deals where you're probably the last car to still alive. Everybody's car is probably already destroyed. Off the road. So there's already one car already totaled. Really hard to handle this man. Man, that's a second car all in total. Wow. Still got 78% of my car left. Man, I'm gonna jump over. Because of that low light, I lost 20% of the power of my car. So that's not good when you knock that much off. And see that? Kind of came down and ran into a parked car. That's another problem. Because then half your damn car is destroyed and didn't even do nothing but land. 25%. There's still another lap to go. If I can finish this lap, I'm gonna get destroyed. There's only me and one other guy left in this lap. Oh man, I knew it. I knew I was gonna hit that freaking car. Energy left, which that was pretty good. That was scary though. So yeah, so yeah, this game is a really good game. I like it a lot. I don't see anything wrong with it. Just like in the previous review I said, the graphics are amazing, the gameplay is great, the control of the game, like the handling of the car, you know, with the controller and everything, it's just beautifully done. I mean, it's just great. It's probably one of the, it's probably one of the best racing games I've played that the control on it is just, like, I mean, the control on this is just, the damage on this game, very realistic. This is awesome. I never played the online one yet, though. I had a friend that played the online one, and he said it's pretty much built for us. So there'll be players on there just trying to piss you off. Run you off the road, not even care about the place, because they don't want you to go first, so they'll run your ass off the road. Which that sounds pretty funny. So yeah, we are playing the Code Champion circuit right now, so this is the hardest of the hardest right now. This is a updated there's something else in there. I know they're supposed to have a lot of updates to this game, but I don't know actually what they're doing with it. I don't know if they're just gonna get cars, or if they're gonna get more tracks, or more upgrades for the game. I don't really know. Guess I need to Google it and see what it all is. See, sometimes it's not all about, you know, burning rubber and, you know, everything. Sometimes it's about patience. Like, even if your car can last through the race. But yeah, I'm still in first place right now. Plus this car is highly modified, so that other car might not be as modified as this one. I just wasted too much time. there is a reset button, you reset, ignition of the car back on the track. I should have did that because I wasted too much time trying to get the film. But if you look at the car damage, whatever the hell you call that, thing on the left side, that tells you what kind of damage your car has. And the main thing you don't want to happen is your wheels just fall off when you're driving on three wheels, because that's when you're actually trying to turn, And then you don't want your brakes to go out, because once you have your brakes come out, you can't use your brakes going around sharp corners, and then, that's some more issues. So you always got to keep an eye on that and make sure it stays good or whatever. Yeah, so this one will be the final race, and I guarantee it's going to be 12 laps. Jesus. It's 6 laps. Oh, yes. 12 laps last in 3 weeks? Well, it gets us behind, but now we only got 9 laps. The power in the middle. I'll make this one. So if you've been playing this game and you like it or don't like it or whatever, comment below and let me know what you think about this game. I've been playing it since it's been out, had a couple of videos on it. Let me know what you think about the game, because I really like it. It's probably the most fun game that even came out. I believe, well, to me anyway, it has a big time replay value, which means, you can play today, tomorrow or the next day, and you won't be tired of it. But you can always try better next time. Racing, leveling up, everybody's disqualified now, so I gotta do 6 more laps. So yeah, that's one of my favorite tracks. It's, you know, awesome track. I love the jumps on it. It's pretty wild. Let's see, I got first anyways. I just didn't achieve any stars just because I didn't finish it and everything. So we are on the World Masters. Let's do the oval track. That's the one. I love this little car right here. This car right here is a badass. So I like the oval tracks too. They're pretty awesome, you know, because it's just straight up speed. So the thing to this is, you're supposed to spin people out and make them wreck, get extra points and stuff, and of course to finish first place and everything. So we got 3 races on this one. see, it sucks is because if you get fourth, you're a nobody because you have to get first through first, second, or third, or nothing counts, so that blows. The last minute I got fourth place, that sucks. I sucked. All because of one little bit.
Person racing, so I don't like that, you know, it's not one part is already up part of it.
We've got 96% car left, the rest of it. See, you got that much left, you can start playing with people. Well, I don't know, really, it's not. I'm gonna totally describe it. Believe it or not, my car is still handling it. That was pretty amazing. Can't believe I got first on that. Wow. That was pretty damn awesome. Pretty awesome. So yeah, I guess I'll finish up the video here. Like I said, that's WreckFest, a very great game. I'll hold the review like I said before. This is a 10 out of a 10 game. I mean, if anybody bitches about anything on this game, you're stupid, because there's nothing wrong with it. Now, before, you know, when the game first came out, you know, loading times were a little slow, you know, and then they did some patches, and now the loading times are, you know, have rise really nicely, so, you know, it doesn't take that long to load. but the car upgrades is awesome. I mean, everything is just awesome. The music's awesome. Everything's awesome. Now, one thing what would be cooler is if they just come out with some more. Let me show you. Come out with some more modifications, some upgrades, like engines and stuff. Oh shit, I gotta update this. But anyways, yeah, you got all these options to, you know, upgrade and stuff like that. And you can see over to the side how much it costs and everything and what it does to your car. And then you got your armor, you know, I think I got all these maxed out. Visuals, and then you change your wheels and your and everything. I just hope they come out with some more upgrades and stuff. Would be pretty dope, you know. But other than that, it's a wonderful game. It's a really fun game, and like I said, it does have an online mode, so you can play with your friends and your family on it, even though I haven't done it yet. I've just been doing the career mode first because I like to do that in games first, do the career, and then go on to the online fun. But it's a good game. There's two versions. There's the, what is it? Yeah, the deluxe edition. This one was $60 standard. PS4 game price, but you know, for the standard price, you get a deluxe edition. You know, now if you want to be a little cheaper and get the deluxe edition, you can get the standard edition for $39.99. Now those are Amazon.com prices, so you have to check on there. It might be a little cheaper now, I don't know, but is the deluxe edition worth it? Yes, because there's going to be either, I can't remember, there's either 7 to 8 DLC packs throughout the year or whatever they're going to bring out. So, you know, get the season pass. So it's worth it. It's worth the extra $20, I think. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video. Like I said, if you haven't tried this game out, you need to. It's on PS4, Xbox, and PC. Thank you for watching Twisted Gaming TV. We'll see you next time. Later.